Okay, back to the stones of the gods there. Stones of the gods, without the. I found almost an exact replica of a volcanic flow somewhere over there in Asia, but now I've since lost the photo. I thought I downloaded it, but I didn't. But the flow itself went exactly precisely the same as my chapter there of the isle. There's the sculpted isle chapter, something like that I called it. But yeah, the isle of, so literally it, what happens is the lava just goes and pushes in and makes these inlets, these little tiny isle inlets. And so that went on, but that theirs over there in Indonesia, they didn't have any sculptures. So they didn't take that sculpture moment. Now I also found, you know, because I did show you the whale there, one of the, that's the medium-sized whale. There's one that's even larger. But there's one in Russia, and they call it a beluga. Oddly, it does, because belugas normally don't look that way, but there is one in Russia near Kamchatka, and it was in a volcanic flow. It appears 40,000 years ago, so they've got that pinned down to that time, but then there's some that say 6,000, so there's a lot of just disagreements on which volcano happened when. But there were two eruptions there, but it did catch a whale. It caught a whale. Now, so it's a similar one that caught a whale, but the one in Corsica is so much better. It's so much more exact that it's like, you know, whoa. But it's the same shine. It has the same sheen on the basalt. Now, you know, basalt, as you go with it, you know, it becomes more and more shiny, and it becomes like just luxurious. The water is what really did it. The water and the age of time is what shined these suckers up. So they're really amazing. Anyway, my little show. I don't know. There's always like, I may move any minute. I may go somewhere. I don't know. I haven't finished this painting, and I guess it could be, you know, ruined. Anyway, there's a little panther in it, and I just wanted to show you. But I haven't finished painting his eye. He only has one eye at the moment. And so that's where I'm at with the panther. And yeah, he's kind of a cutie. And I think that's it. There's no other animals in it. This one was just kind of just the panther and the flowers. But oh my gosh. So yeah, so that's a great discovery, because now I have absolutely almost like the precise inlet design happening somewhere else on the planet with their volcano flow. So that what that does is that's the proof in the tale that that's an exact another exact moment of where it happened, of where a volcano made that exact, you know what I mean, look, the exact look of the land, you know, that's incredible. So they flowed the same way. That's what we're looking at. Somewhere called Puhk San or something like that. I'm not really great with it, with the name, but yeah, someplace out there like that. So we have the bay with we found the larger, you know somebody's very proud of their whale fossil, and so now we have this other. So we have a volcano whale up there, and then we have another three. I have three volcano whales down in the Corsica one, and this one little Tyugga site. So it's kind of exciting. I have the baby whale, I have the silly fish. Now, when we talk about the silly fish, I'll put an image out on him. A very, very interesting algae eater, Placostomus style. Unbelievable. With the front four mouth area. Now, I have not seen this. I've looked under ancient prehistorics. I have not found one. There's a few that do have creepy crawlers out the front nostril area, quite long extension antennas. There's a few like that that have maybe 30 or 40 tentacles for their lips in the upper and 30, 40 for the tentacles at the bottom. So those are a really neat fish, but I have not found this one silly fish, and so he's eluding everybody so far. I haven't seen a picture of him. So he's only at this point captured in stone, and that's where we're at with the silly fish. There is a kind of a look-alike, but he doesn't have the same mouth structure. There's a look-alike with the fin and the tail out there, but not with the same sucker mouth feature. So the silly fish is like one of my favorite stones out of all of them. And yay. So, I get so excited over the site, and yet I did not go and return, and I didn't have the time nor the money to do that. So it's kind of a shame, isn't it? Because probably the people who live there don't even care, but live there their whole lives. They're just the stones that are there, but... In the same token, I don't know. It's a really kind of a neat place, and it deserves a lot of, I don't know. Maybe all archaeologists on the planet need to buy houses there. Maybe that's just gonna have to be a place that we're to live. Put them all there, and anthropologists and all, and you just get to study. And that, therefore, it gets protected, a little bit more. So I'm a little bit into this weird kind of protectionism stance of myself right now, how to protect things. They just take that group that's really interested and have them move into it, have them live there. And then you'll have a higher ratio of protections with saving it. And not having some jerk with a bulldozer show up and say, "Hey, I just need boulders for my house," because that's what people do. They don't seem to respect the past. That's where we're at. We have to protect it. We have to make it mandated as a site, a historical site forever. And even make decisions like, are we going to recarve? Are we going to continue the carving? Are we going to improve the carvings? I mean, once we've seen them, once we've pronounced that's the way it was, why do we have to keep the real uglies and hideous? Can't we go further and carve them, just as the Egyptians? Why can't we continue and make it something beautiful? Yeah, so we're a lot of times stuck with that. When you look at antiquities, you're like, well, I'm not going to go into Greece and recarve the pillars in Athens, but maybe after a while, the tourists start to want to look at the real thing. They're tired of looking at it all, and so then they start repairing it, and so the same goes for this site. We end up with, we have to repair it, and we have to make it look beautiful again. And how, the problem is, when you go back with anthropology, it's so new that we don't even know all about all the tribes that were there. We do not know about all the species of this Homo erectus man that even lived there. There were probably so many that passed through this island over time. Yeah, even little hobbits. all kinds of exciting. We have to preserve it. That's where we're at right now. We just have to preserve it, and then make final decisions on revamping it. You know. Anyway, that's enough for that discussion.